家好，欢迎收听今天的早安英文口语急救包栏目，我是卡拉。
And this is Dylan.
Hello, welcome to Morning English.早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
So Kara,Do you have any plans this weekend?
No, why?
I'm having a wine tasting and you should come. We'll have cheese and about 10 different types of wine.
I'd love to.
Oh, okay, great. The party starts at 5 p.m. and goes until about 9. There will be parking in the underground garage under my house. I'll send you the address.
所以呢，我们今天要跟大家聊的这个话题就是怎么样去邀约别人。
So we have to divide these into three different columns, okay?
Yeah.
Friends, co-workers, and strangers.
我们呢会分三种不同的情况，因为三种不同情况的邀约在这个措辞上面也会有一些差别，那分别是比较亲密的朋友和这个不是那么亲近的同事，以及在路上搭讪陌生人分别要怎么讲。首先呢，我们来聊一聊亲密的朋友之间要怎么邀约。
So when talking about hanging out or asking someone to hang out, that person is almost always talking about spending time with friends, okay?
所以呢，如果说你和朋友一起出去啊，这种我们属于 hang out.
Yeah, it's a very colloquial way to say spend time together. When asking a friend out, you can be more direct and to the point, okay? Here's an example. Hey, Paul, you want to come over this Friday and watch the game?
对，在你邀请这个比较亲密的朋友的时候，就不需要那么拐弯抹角，也不需要说一些客客气气的话了，就直接讲就好了。比如说，Hey, Paul, 你想要星期五过来一起看比赛吗？之类的。
Yeah.Another example of asking a friend out would be something like, what's up, Kara? Do you have plans this Saturday? I'm going to have a few friends over for games and drinks. Do you want to come?
那关于这样子的邀约要怎么回答呢？同样是直接随意一点就好了。A simple yes or no will suffice. 就是直接回答去或者不去 yes or no 就好了。当然了，如果说你不去的话呢， it's common courtesy to explain why.
Yeah, so you could also say, no, sorry, I have plans already, but thanks for the invite. Or you could also say, I would love to, but I will be out of town.
就是你可以说，我想去，但是呢，我已经有其他的安排了，已经有约了，或者说，我想去，但是那个时候我可能不在这里，所以就是如果不去的话，还是要说明一下原因，这样子让人觉得比较真诚一些。
Now let's talk about making an appointment with colleagues or clients.
第二种情况呢，我们来聊一聊，就是相对比较正式的，同事或者说不那么熟的朋友之间的邀约。那通常呢，如果说是同事之间的邀约，我们叫做 appointment。那这个时候呢，通常你就 require a little more information about the subject you are talking about.
Exactly. Instead of just giving the time, you should give the location and the subject of the meeting or appointment. As an example, you could say,The meeting about the merger is on the second floor at 3 p.m. today. Will I see you there?
在这种情况下呢，我们就需要更多的信息。通常情况下 ，the first thing one should talk about when scheduling a meeting or an appointment is time, because the whole appointment of a meeting or appointment is to get together at the same time.
Yeah, the second thing we should talk about is the location of the meeting.
最后呢 ，last but not least.Is the topic of the meeting or the appointment. The person may already have a vague idea of what the meeting is about, but it is considered polite to remind the person when asking.
Oh, that reminds me, Kara. Will you be at the meeting this afternoon?
There's a meeting this afternoon?
Yeah, in Mike's office. He's going to give out bonuses to all the good employees.
Oh, I didn't get an invite.
Ah, I guess you're not a good employee then.When talking about strangers, it is best to be formal and not come across as too eager. Don't ask the person out right away. Try to get to know the person first and find common interests.
You mean like asking someone on a date?
Exactly, yeah.
像这种呢，就是陌生人之间的搭讪啊，邀约的话，通常就是以一个 date 为目的，就是那种怎么说呢，像是情侣之间 relationship 的那种约会。
Exactly. Try not to be too forward with the person. Remember when I said hang out almost always refers to friends? Well, it can also, in this case, mean go on a date.
也就是说在这种情况下啊，因为你是邀约陌生人，那你就好像不想要显得太怪异了，然后也不要太直接了，你们可以先去开始一段其他的对话，找一找共同的兴趣爱好，然后呢再邀约。那么邀约的时候呢也可以委婉一点，因为我们前面讲了 hang out 是朋友之间的一起出去玩，比较 casual 随意的一个氛围，那你也可以用这个词说 do you want to hang out together sometime， 但是呢其实这个时候它指的是一个 date。
Yeah, so in English it's a little more complicatedBecause you have to be very clear what your interests are without being too sexual or overly sexual.
就是你一方面要展示自己对他有兴趣，但是一方面呢又不要太 eager 的感觉。
Yeah, but you should also give that person little hints that you're interested in taking them out.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, so let's do some example sentences, okay? The first one is, can I have your phone number or WeChat?
就进行了一番聊天之后呢，你就可以问说，哎，我可以要一下你的手机号或者微信吗？
Are you doing anything on Friday? So Friday or any weekday, Saturday or Sunday are considered like the date days, okay? The date days in Western culture.
啊，所以你就可以问说，哎，你星期五或者说星期六有什么安排吗？因为在西方的文化里面，感觉这两天就是那个 date day 约会日的感觉。
Next one is, do you want to go out sometime?
什么时候一起出去玩一玩
And the next one is, can I take you out to dinner?
叫我们一起出去吃个饭呗。
And remember, these are only said after a conversation has taken place, after you established some rapport with that person.
对，这个已经强调很多次了，一定不要一上去就对人陌生人讲这样子的话啊，先去扯一扯谈，聊一聊天，找一找兴趣爱好，然后呢找准时机问出这么一句话。
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
Okay, guys, well, thank you for joining us today on Morning English. This has been your host, Dylan.
我是卡拉。
Have a good day.
Bye-bye.